Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you basic image editing using Preview. So I'm using Preview version 7 here, and you can open lots of different types of files in Preview, like PDFs, but you can also open images. So we're going to open an image file, and once we have it open, there are a lot of things we can do to edit this. It's not as comprehensive as, say, using a tool like Photoshop, but there's some basic things that we can do with the image. So let's start off by bringing up the editing tools. And I can do that by clicking this button here, and it brings up this extra toolbar. And there are several different tools you've got in here, most of which have to do with annotations or making selections, not really necessarily to do with image editing. We can adjust size, though, which will allow us to resize this image. Say this is something we're going to post online, and this is, you know, pretty large image here. So we can reduce its size, maybe to like 400 by 300, for instance. We can set whether or not we want it to scale, whether or not it, you know, we can just pick a custom size there, or a, you know, specific size like 320 by 240, and we can resize the image like that. And there we go. We can also zoom in. I'm going to use the Command Plus to zoom in. It's under the View menu. You can do zoom in, zoom out, and actual size would be zero. So that's Command Zero gets you that, and that's the actual size of it, which. It looks pretty good, especially for something posting online. So certainly doing this will reduce its size. So now we can export it. That would be reduce its size. And exporting is an important part of this. We can select a format, and JPEG is probably what we want to use. We'll give it a name, dash small, so we know it's small. And we can adjust the JPEG quality. So we can, for instance, create a really low quality but very small file, or go to high quality, very large file, or choose something there in the middle. So let's just choose right there, 21K, not bad. We can also make color adjustments to this. Here's the button for color adjustments, and it brings up the same panel that we'll see, say, in iPhoto, except we don't have to actually bring this photo into our iPhoto library to adjust it. So we can make these adjustments as well and get the picture to be more like what we want. We can also crop the photo by using the rectangular selection tool, and take a selection like this, make an adjustment or two to it, and then we'll see under Tools we have Crop. And now we've cropped it, and you'll notice there were a bunch of other tools. There was rotating, flipping, so you can actually do a lot if the image was rotated the wrong way. For instance, you could rotate it right here in Preview and then export it, and you'll get the resulting image. You could also copy and paste. I can make the selection here, or just select all, and I could copy. And let's open up another image here, say just this one, and then I could paste this image on top of the first one. So you can see you can combine images. You could even create a new document, although in a little bit of a tricky way. I've selected and copied this here, so I say new from clipboard. Now I have a second document called Untitled that's never been saved, and it has this image in it. Now I could go and adjust its size. Let's do that. Adjust it to fit without scaling and do 200 across, 200% across. So I'm going to end up with an image that's really long like that. And that's not what I want. What I want is be able to paste this in the left and another image on the right. So I can paste again in here, since I still have this copied. And you see it pastes another copy of it, but this one is not scaled. So I can move this over to the left. And then say if I opened up another image like this one, I could copy it and paste it here like that. Now I still have this new unsaved document called Untitled, and I can now export